Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. All right, here's a trig problem we're going to solve. If the cosine of 2a equals 1/3 and 360 degrees is less than 2a, which is less than 450 degrees, this is saying something about what quadrant 2a is in. Find the cosine of a, the sine of a, and the tangent of a. So what we're given is the cosine of 2a, and we're trying to find the cosine of a. First off, no, you can't just divide by 2 and say it's 1/6. These are two totally different angles. So what we can do is think, well, if we know the cosine of 2a, do we have a formula that we've got the cosine of 2a in? Well, how about the formula for the cosine of 2a? The formula for the cosine of 2a, there are different ones, but one of them is 2 cosine squared a minus 1. That's one formula. So if we know the cosine of 2a is 1/3, we could replace cosine of 2a with 1/3. And we have 1/3 equals 2 cosine squared a minus 1. And we're trying to find the cosine of a, because that's why I use this formula, right? So if I could solve this equation for the cosine of a, I'll be done. Now, from here, there's different ways you can solve it. I'm going to do it by multiplying both sides by the least common multiple, which is 3, to get rid of the fractions. Okay? So I'm just multiplying on both sides of the equation 3. So 3 times 1/3 is 1. 3 times, and then I have the equal, 3 times 2 cosine squared a is 6 cosine squared a. And 3 times 1 is 3. And then we have to add 3 to both sides. So we have 4 equals 6 cosine squared a. Got a little extra mark there. And then we could divide both sides by 6. And so we have the 2/3 equals cosine squared a. So I'm going to write that as cosine squared a equals 2/3. And now here's where the trick comes in. We would take the square roots of both sides, right? But we have to decide when you take the square root, usually you put plus or minus, but we know the cosine of this particular angle A in this problem can't be two different answers. So we go back up to what other information do we have? Well, we've got that 360 degrees is less than 2a is less than 450. So if we look at this, we could divide all sides by 2 to find out where a is. So 360 divided by 2 is 180. 2a divided by 2 is a. And 450 divided by 2 is 225. So this tells you something about where a is, and that's in quadrant 3. And in quadrant 3, the cosine is negative. All right, so we know we're going to choose the negative square root here. So when I take the square root of both sides, I need to take the square root of 2/3, but it's going to be negative the square root of 2/3, not positive the square root of 2/3. So that'll give me the square root of 2 over the square root of 3, and then I'm going to just multiply numerator and denominator by square roots of 3 because we want to rationalize our denominator. So the cosine of a is negative square roots of 6 over 3. And that's how we can get the cosine of a. Now we could go and use the other formula for the cosine of 2a and do the whole thing again to figure out what the sine of a. So one approach would be you would write the formula cosine of 2a is 1 minus 2 sine squared a, and we could solve for the sine of a doing the same thing. We already found out that A is in quad 3, so it's going to be negative. So one way is we can go through this whole process, do exactly the same thing, put in 1/3, multiply everything by 3. And solve this. I'm just going to bring the sine squared to the left, so it'll be 6 sine squared a equals 2, and then divide both sides by 6 to get the sine squared a is 1/3. And then when I take the square root again, because a is in quadrant 3, I'm going to take negative the square root. So I'm going to get the square root of 1, which is just going to be 1 over the square root of 3. Multiply square root of 3 over 3. So the sine is negative square root of 3. So by using this formula, I was able to find the sine of A. Now, you didn't actually have to go through all this work. You could have used the information you got about the cosine here. So we had that the cosine was negative square roots of 6 over 3, right? And in fact, we had the cosine squared of A was 2/3. We could have used the Pythagorean theorem, I'm sorry, the Pythagorean identity, cos squared A plus sine squared A equals 1 to find the sine of A as well. In other words, the cosine squared A, well, it's right here, 2/3, plus sine squared A equals 1. Subtract 2/3 from both sides. And take the square root, and we would end up with exactly the same answer. The square, and we would take negative because it's in quad 3. Remember, A is in quad 3, so the sine of A is negative. That's why I'm going to use this negative sign here. Don't know what happened there. I just seemed to accidentally get rid of that. So I'm going to get the square root of 1 over the square root of 3. Again, we're going to get negative square roots of 3. So you really have two ways of figuring out what the sine of A. I'd say this is easier, but if you don't think of that, you might just go to this step here. Use the formula for cosine of 2a and figure out what the sine is. You also could have found out the sine first and then figured out the cosine. You also could have drawn a picture to figure it out. You could have said, well, I'm in quad 3. And remember, our first thing we found out, the cosine of a was negative square roots of 6 over 3. All right, and the cosine could be thought of as the x value over the radius. So if this is the radius of 3 and this is negative square roots of 6, you could just use the Pythagorean theorem to figure out this length here for y to get the cosine. So y squared plus a negative square roots of 6 squared will just be a positive 6. So we'd have that the y value is plus or minus square roots of 3. And in this case, again, you can see the y is going down, so it's in the third quadrant. So it's negative square roots of 3. And so the sine of A from this picture, right, I can now say that this is actually negative square roots of 3 would be the y value over the radius. So it's negative square roots of 3. Looking at the picture, we could also get the tangent. The tangent is the y over the x, so I would have negative square roots of 3 over negative square roots of 6. Which is square root of 3 over square root of 6, or square root of 1/2. I'm just going to multiply by 2 over 2 inside to get square roots of 2 over 2. So here's the tangent. Here's the sine, and here's the cosine. So once you get one of them, you could draw the picture. That's one way of doing it, or You could use the formula, right, to get the sine of it, or you could have used the Pythagorean theorem. I'm sorry, the Pythagorean identity here, the main one, to get this negative square roots of 3. All right, so there's an example of how you, one way of working this problem. You could also use half-angle identities. There's other ways to come up with the same answer, but be careful of your signs, etc. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.